Welcome to Guru Institute. Good evening, children. In the previous class, we are discussing about the total 12 lessons of the our physical science. Today, we are going to start the our first lesson, that is light. In the light lesson, in our regular academic section, we have the three lessons. The first lesson is reflection of light, and the fourth lesson in your textbook, that is refraction of light, and the fifth lesson is human eye and colorful wall. Before going to this, we have to learn about the some basic things of the what is the light. Already in the 8th class and 9th class, he has given the basics, and the 10th class is directly entering into the reflection of light at curved surfaces. So first, now we are discussing about the basic light. Actually, what is mean by light, Nana? Light is nothing but brightness. In our daily life, we are regularly use the word. What is that? A synonym word is brightness. From where we get the brightness? This brightness from early morning. If you wake up, if you see that one, where you get the brightness? At the night time, we didn't get the as much as brightness from the daytime. From this one, we know that the brightness we will get from the sun, right? Yes or no? This is the sun. So from this one, we can conclude that sun is the major light source to our galaxy. What is our galaxy? Milky Way. So for our galaxy Milky Way, sun is the major light source. So from this one, already you know that. So have you ever draw a sun diagram in the childhood? How did you draw this one? I will draw the two pictures. So from that one, you can compare and tell me the answer. So the first picture is round shape. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this parallelly. So then I am going to draw the second picture is like this. In the childhood or from now, how can you draw the pictures? Sun picture. As you draw like this or like this? First picture is correct or second picture is correct? Which is the correct, Nana? Which one? Yes. Always from childhood onwards, we are drawing like this. So the first picture is correct. This one is the wrong. Why we are not drawing like this? There is any reason? Yes. Behind this one, some reason is there. That is the only our basic light topic. So this is the basic. What is the major picture of the light? That means sun. So from this one, we can conclude the some basic principles of light. So this is the sun. These are called what, Nana? What is that? This one? Rays, right? That is the what? Sun rays. Sun rays means what is this one? From this one, what we will get? Brightness. Brightness what? What will get? Light. So we can conclude this one. These are called what? Light rays. Okay, right. So they are a straight one or curved one. In the second picture, what we are seeing the curved picture, but these are the straight one. So from this one, what we can consider? These are the straight lines. And so these are straight lines. These are light rays, and you are getting the early morning after sunrise. You are getting the light very fast onto the earth or very slowly. Yes, obviously it is a very very fast in nature. So that's why it will travel in a high speed manner, and it will take the shortest distance path. You are getting speed means what? It takes the always shortcut. That means shortest distance path. So these are the basic natures of the light rays. What are those? Light is in the form of rays. First one. So the second one is it is always in the form of straight line. And the third one is it always takes the shortest path. These three are the what is that? Basic characteristics of the light. Basic characteristics of the light are three rules. So no need to by heart you have. So simply we have to remember about the what is that? Sun. So already we know the sun picture. From that you can derive this one. So that rays are straight line one. So that is a straight line. Always we call as a rays, shortest distance path. So the characteristics of the light are three. First one, The light is always in the form of rays and always in the form of straight line. It will take the shortest path. Right. And one more the basic characteristic is, what is light first of all? So, if you stand upon the open atmosphere, that means open air in the morning time, if you expose to the sunlight very much, that means sunshine, so then what will happen? Your body gets heated. That means what happened? Heat is nothing but some of the energy. You are getting some energy or not? So, from this one, we can conclude that it is a form of, what is that? Form of energy. Right. It is a form of energy or source of energy. So, from this one, we can conclude that a simply thing, light is a form of energy. It should be travel in the form of rays and it should be in the straight line path and it covers the shortest distance path. Rays means, what do you mean by ray? It has a starting point, it has a no ending point. These are the characteristics of the light. So, then coming to the, these are the characteristics, cutting nothing but nature. Along with this one, so every human body has some nature, every person. And along with this one, every person has his unique identity. Like that, light also some its identity. That means light also some properties it is having. That properties are, what are those mean? These are the characteristics. So now we are going to discuss the, properties. What are the properties? Only two properties are there. Light has the two properties. So the two properties are, first one, reflection. What is that? Reflection. And the second property of the light is called refraction. So, are you listening these words? Yeah, these are the lesson names. Reflection and refraction. These two are the basic properties of the light. These two are the basic properties of the light. Reflection and refraction. So, now we are going to discuss the, what is the basic nature? That means, what is reflection? What is refraction? Already in the 8th class, he has given the idea about reflection. In the 9th standard, he has given the idea about the refraction. So, coming to this one, reflection. Reflect. What is meant by reflect? It should be reflected. Have you ever seen the mirror? What we call, if I have seen the anything in the mirror, what we call it is reflected, reflected. Okay, now simply we have to take some example. Suppose if you take some ball, right? Now take the ball and in your home or at the open space, that is you have to throw it onto the wall. What will happen? It will go and hit the wall and it again return back, right? It going and hitting and coming back. So that means return back. So like this, return property is called reflection. Like this also, a light ray is falls on any non-transparent body. Not transparent body, any non-transparent body, it will hit that body and again return back as it is. So that return back property is called reflection. So reflection means what, Nana? Simply for understanding purpose, I am writing like this: return back. Example, mirror. Now take a for this proof. What is the ball is a general example, right? For this one, if you understood this one, now take up on torch lights. Okay, torch light. What happens if you switch on that one? It will give the beam of light, right? Beam of light means some branch of light that is coming. It is a straight line one. So now take the mirror. Do you know the mirror? Daily morning for your fresh up and your makeup, you are taking the mirror, right? So take the mirror and keep like this and keep the, what is that? Your torch light onto the mirror. What will happen, Anna? It will again return back. It is passing through the mirror? Nothing. It won't pass through the mirror. It is fall on the mirror and again it unable to go to the back side and again it come back. So that is return back. So that is called reflection. Are you clear? Okay. So the best example for reflection property we are using is mirror. So then coming to the next one, refraction. This is one return back. Suppose if it is not return back, okay, right? Some more example, simple logic. We are moving in one room. So, room, if you are moving in a room, if one wall is coming to you in front of you, then again you take a diversion and go, you are coming, return back. So that is a reflection. Suppose if there is no wall, there is only some entrance, that means some gate is there. What will happen? You are easily passed through the entrance. So and that means you are entered into the another room. So like that only. If any light ray, suppose we are taking the example, what, Anna? Mirror. So in place of mirror, if you take the, what is that, glass. In our physical science, it is called as a lens. What is that? Lens. So if you take the open glass or your window glass, what will happen? Again, you have to take the, what is that, torchlight. Then if you keep falling on that one, it will falling on that one, it won't return back. What will happen? It is passing through the that glass material and enter into the another side. But little bit bending will be takes place. Suppose if you flowing like this, it is falling on that, what is the, that glass, and in place of mirror, it is falling on the mirror and return back. But in case of glass, what will happen? It is making, that means it will going, it will falling onto the glass and it is passing through the glass and enters into the another side. But in that one, little bit bending will be takes place. It falling like this, little bit bending like this, bending takes place. Again, it will go in a straight line manner. That means it is passing through the object, right? So simply refraction means you have to remember the passing through. What is that? Passing through. So from this we can write the, we can know the definition of the refraction of light. What is that mean? Simply listen, just 30 seconds. One. What is that? If any light ray is falling on transparent body, then it is passing through that body and bent and enter into the another side of the body. So that is called refraction of light. Okay, Nana? Are you now understood the differences? Simple logic, Nana. Here what we are taking? Okay, we have now observed. Reflection means return back. The best example is mirror. Refraction, that means passing through. The best example is glass. In this one, we are taking the, which one? In this one, we are taking the non-transparent body. Non-transparent body. Okay, right? In this one, we are taking the, which one, Anna? Transparent body. First of all, I have one doubt here. Sir, up to now you are telling, you are talking about the non-transparent, transparent, transparent, non-transparent. Actually, what is meant by transparent? What is meant by non-transparent? Okay, let's see. Transparent means, if you are able to see the other side, that means if you are taking any object like this, if you are able to see the another side objects from this one, then now this is a transparent. If you are unable to see the another side, then that is called a non-transparent. Are you clear? My hand is a transparent or non-transparent? This is obviously non-transparent. I can't able to see the other side through this hand. Suppose if you take the one of the light cloth, like chunis, whatever it may be, if you open like this, curtain, some of the lightweight curtains, we are not, we are slightly see about the other sides. Or if you take the glass, clearly you are seeing the other side of the, what is that, object. So that is a transparent. If you see the other side, there is a transparent. If you can't see the objects of the other side, that is a non-transparent. Simply, this is a non-transparent object. So that's why light is falling on this one. Suppose let me, this board is a non-transparent. Obviously, board is a non-transparent. So, suppose it is a mirror totally, light is falling on this one, it is return back. Why? Because it is unable to go through this one. So, that's why that is a reflection. So, then, now, let me assume that this board is a, what is that? So, this one is a, some of the glass, glass material, if you take this one. So, it is a obviously non-transparent, it is falling on this one. It is able to do, going through the pass this one, but before going to that one, it will pass through the width of the glass. So, that's why it will little bit bending. Falling like this, little bending and enters into the other side. This is about the refraction of light. Okay, children, today we are just discussing about the only basic definitions of reflection and refraction. In the next class, we are going to discuss the, what is the main property of reflection, what is the main properties of refraction, and their, what is that, ray diagrams, how they will be like this. So, this is the introduction. So, totally this introduction, simply this is not the 10th class concept, 8th and 9th class concept. So, after 3 or 4 classes, we are entering into our first chapter, reflection of light at curved surfaces. Okay, Nana? Thank you very much for all. Just regularly watch our channel, that means our institute. So, you will be get updated this one. So, if you have any doubts, please post on the comment box. We will give the reply for you. Okay. Thank you very much. Very soon we will provide the some contact number also for you. Thank you for your support. If your friends are there, just refer to them for your regular 10th class updates. Okay. Thank you very much.